this video, as the title suggests, we're going to solve this quadratic equation in three different ways to find the two solutions we have. Alright, so I'm going to put the whole first solution up and just walk you through it step by step. Method 1 involves completing the square. So from this line to this line, what we've done is subtracted 21 from both sides just to get it out of the way. And with these lines, we've just taken out a factor of 2. So to check if we multiply this out, we get 2x squared plus 13x, so that's a perfectly legitimate move. Then we've taken what's inside this bracket here, and we've done something called completing the square. What you do is you halve the x coefficient, and then you do x plus, you have to subtract that term squared from it, because if we multiply this out, so you get x squared plus 13 over 4x plus 13 over 4x plus 169 over 16. But to be equal to this, you then have to subtract the 169 over 16. So here we go. And the reason this is useful is now we do the 2 times this and add it to both sides. And that gives us 1 over 8. Then dividing by 2 gives us x plus 13 over 4 squared is equal to 1 over 16. And the reason this is useful now is because when we take the square root, we have x with no square involved, which means we can now solve for it. You know, we couldn't rearrange and solve for it here because we have an x squared and an x, so we can't take any. So this trick allows us to do that. So we take the positive minus square root of 13 over from each side gives the x to minus 3.5 or actually minus 3. You can check that, feel free to check these above, and we'll get the same solution for every single method we use today. It's just to give you a few different options to solve. I'll check minus 3 now you check. So minus 3 squared is 9, times by 2 is 18, 13 times minus 3 is minus 39. And add 21, so that does give us 0, so that is. On to the next method. Here is using the quadratic formula, which is stated x is equal to minus b plus or minus square root of b squared minus c. A, B, and C are. A, B, and C are the coefficient respectively. So A is the x squared coefficient, B is the x coefficient, and C is this constant on the end. To find A, B, and C, you have to make sure your quadratic is in the form A squared plus B x plus C is equal to 0. If you've got things over there, you know, confused, it's okay, everything over to one side then. Everything in front of the x squared is your a, everything in front of the x is your b, and everything else is your c. You plug it into this formula, remember to find the plus and minus solutions. And you know, you can check this for yourselves, but if you put all these numbers in, you do get, as before, minus 3 and minus 3 now. So for this final method, it's a classic method, we're going to factorise it. We've got double brackets, which can be tough, a lot of just trial and error, trying different numbers, but there's a few tips that really help with this one. If we're looking at how to get our coefficient for A, the only way to do x times two more put together, and 2 is prime, so that means we know that the only two numbers that multiply to get 2 are 2 multiplied by 1. That's all you can do. So this and those terms were set already. And then after that, it's a little bit of a trial and error. We're looking at this last term. We need these two at the end to multiply to 1. So we have 1 and 21. We have minus 1 and minus 21. We have 7 and 3. And minus 7 and minus 3. And we just have to try these in different combinations in the upper different brackets. See which one gives us the 13x term in the middle. And that's our factorised form. In this case, we can check it. If we do 2x half of x, we get our 2x squared, 2x plus 3 is 6, so plus the 7x here, so that's 13x plus 21, so this is equivalent to that. But from this we can see this to equal 0, and then 2x plus 7 to equal to 0, or 3 plus x to equal to 0. And solving these equations gives minus 3, or minus 3 and a half as before. So, that's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed and I hope you found it helpful. Thank you very much for watching.